This picture was taken by the ESA's Sentinel-2 satellite in August 2021. In this picture, the Mount Etna volcano erupts for the 50th time within the year. Mount Etna is the most active volcano in Europe. Every time it erupts, it gets taller due to the accumulation of ejected lava. In 2021 alone, the volcano has grown about 30 meters taller. Although Mount Etna was once underwater, today it's the tallest volcano in Europe. Its height reaches 3,357 meters above sea level. And it doesn't just grow. Mount Etna brings death. It covers 2.5 times the area of Vesuvius. And since the 13th century BC, the volcano has drowned several cities and hundreds of thousands of people in its boiling lava. In the past, its eruptions caused droughts and landslides. In 2020, the volcano came back to life. The ash plumes rose as high as 5 kilometers. All flights through the area had to be canceled, and maybe that's just the beginning. But what other volcanoes are about to become active? What will happen if volcanoes go extinct? Why don't people leave the slopes near dangerous volcanoes? And what's the real danger of eruptions? Not all of Earth's volcanoes are active, but it doesn't mean they're harmless. In 1912, the entire city of Kodiak in Alaska went dark for 2.5 days. Residents claimed they couldn't even see a flashlight at arm's length. Buildings crumbled under the 30-centimeter layer of ash. The reason for this was the eruption and the birth of a new volcano, Nova Rupta. This resulted in an entire valley filled with ash. The eruption lasted 60 hours, and it was the largest disaster in Alaskan state history. The rumble of the eruption was heard 1,200 kilometers away in the city of Juneau. However, layers of ash do seem safer than layers of lava. In 1783, half of all livestock and a quarter of all sheep and horses in Iceland were buried alive. The Laki volcano spewed 42 billion tons of basaltic lava onto the surface, burying 2,500 square kilometers of inhabited land. The ensuing starvation killed 1/5 of the Icelandic population and many more people outside of its borders. When the eruption products made their way into the Gulf Stream, the flow spread them around the world. People died from poisoning in the British Isles and throughout Europe. And this wasn't the only case in which water made things worse. In 1883, a 40-meter tsunami destroyed more than 150 villages on the Indonesian coast. The same number of people were injured. The tsunami was caused by a shockwave induced by the eruption of the Krakatoa volcano. It was the loudest noise that was ever heard in recorded history. The sound traveled a distance of more than 4,800 kilometers from the volcano. Atmospheric shockwaves circled the Earth 7 times and were still felt 5 days later. The total number of fatalities was at least 36,000. Today, these volcanoes are dormant. However, even all three of them put together are not as destructive as one supervolcano. The thing about supervolcanoes is that their eruptions can lead to apocalyptic changes on the planet. The hazard of a supervolcano eruption is comparable to an asteroid impact. They emit clouds of hot gases and ash, which consists of loose particles of obsidian, volcanic glass. When it's released into the environment, all that material creates a kind of reflective screen that barely allows light to pass through. The planet simply freezes. The good news is that they only erupt about once every 100,000 years. The bad news is that for some volcanoes, that time has already come. Thus, Mount Etna pales in comparison with the Yellowstone supervolcano. The last time Yellowstone erupted was 640,000 years ago. The eruption resulted in the complete evacuation of magma reserves beneath the volcano and a crater collapse to boot. That's why the Yellowstone volcano doesn't look like a mountain. It's a caldera, a volcanic depression. Last time, the volcano spewed more than 1,000 cubic kilometers of dust and lava into the atmosphere. That would be enough to cover a large city with a several kilometer thick layer of dust. Although this time, it's not waking up alone, but simultaneously with another supervolcano, the Long Valley Caldera. In March 2016, its seismic activity surpassed Yellowstone's. This was evidenced by a series of earthquakes throughout California. Due to the threat of a super eruption, the U.S. government, under NASA's auspices, is funding projects to prevent it. One of the ideas brought forward is to cool the magma beneath Yellowstone by drilling holes and injecting water. But why is it better for us if volcanoes keep erupting? Without volcanoes, there would be much less destruction on Earth. But active volcanoes are a good sign that there's still some energy within the planet. The eruptions release the heat that the Earth accumulated at the very beginning of its formation. The Earth is gradually cooling down, and it's better not to hurry this along. If the volcanoes stop erupting, agriculture will come to an end. That's because, together with the lava, a large amount of soil nutrients, such as metals, salts, and minerals, come to the surface. No minerals would mean no new calcium, iron, sodium, or potassium. Without them, fertile soils will be depleted. That's why people don't leave the slopes of Mount Etna, and why they return there after eruptions. The slopes are just too fertile to leave. In addition, without volcanoes, there would be no copper, zinc, gold, or platinum, and the jewelry, electronic, and electrical industries would collapse. A stone age would reign once again in the world. But that's not the worst part. The scariest part is that volcanoes play a crucial role in the carbon cycle. Disrupting its flow would kill all plants, and without new plants, there'd be no oxygen. If volcanoes stop erupting, all living things will slowly start dying. In this regard, the Earth would become like its lifeless planetary neighbors. The thing is that a volcanic eruption is the result of tectonic plate movement. Tectonic activity is essential for life. For example, most of Venus is composed of basaltic rocks once ejected with lava. And Mars has the largest volcano in the solar system, Olympus Mons. However, Venus doesn't have plate tectonics due to the high temperature on its surface. And as for Mars, even if it was tectonically active, it was only during its first 100,000 years. Lack of tectonic activity on both planets led to the disappearance of carbon dioxide and complete sterilization. In fact, active volcanoes have been spotted on Io, Jupiter's moon. Telescopes detected the ejection of matter up to 150 kilometers high. However, the reason for this is not tectonic plate movement, but Io's position relative to Jupiter. Io regularly finds itself between Jupiter and its other moons, leading to strong tidal heating. But overactive volcanism makes the moon's surface uninhabitable. This video could instill fear in some of you or increase your worries, just like Mount Etna did to the residents of Italy and all of Europe. But look at this picture of the Mount Etna crater.
You shouldn't be afraid of volcanoes. In fact, you should give them a like.